Russ Simmons, Fox 4, Kansas City.
Hi,
Ms.
Russ.
Taylor, how are you?
Good. How are you?
I'm doing well. Thank you.
Good.
Hey, I was curious. When Dion came through Kansas City and visited our station last year to promote The Intruder, did you come with him?
I was not with him. I was back, you know, grinding it out like I have to do while he gets to do all the fun stuff.
Did he at least bring you some barbecue?
I got the, yes, I got this barbecue sauce and some French fry seasoning or something.
Excellent.
That I'm still using right now, actually, the seasoning. It's so good.
Good deal. Yeah. You know, Fatale is like other film noir thrillers in some ways, but it's unique in other aspects. So could you tell me, without giving too much away, how you would contrast it with other film noir movies?
I mean, you know, there's so many twists and turns throughout the film. I think, you know, just when you think it's predictable, it's not. You know, it takes you on this roller coaster ride that you're going to never expect. I think the talent, for one, is amazing. Seeing them outside of their normal box is really cool for Hillary and Michael to see. But you know, it's just a fun movie, and everybody, I think, will identify with it in some ways. And all these characters are flawed in this film. And mm-hmm. you know, you go along for their journey every step of the way, because it affects everybody in a different way.
Now, the cinemas will be showing this in our area. However, most people are probably going to see it at home. Had you known that, do you think you guys would have made the film any differently?
Well, when we made the film, it was pre-COVID. And so our initial release was in June, and then it switched to October. So we had no idea that we would be in this place. But I do think Lionsgate did a really good job of figuring out a way and navigating a way to put this out smart. Although some people may be a little apprehensive about going to the theaters, there are others that we'll trust the process. I think cinemasafe.org is doing a great job to show you what they've done and implemented to prove that. But you know, listen, hey, we'll take what we can get. I think the movie experience is, it's one thing that I love, like having that actual theater experience that I'll always be on the sideline rooting for. So to be able to still have that is great. And then shortly after, you know, everybody could see it in their home. So, I mean, it's a win-win. It's the holidays. It's when you're with your friends and your family. So I think it's going to be really successful, and you got to change with the times. And so we're excited to be able to be one of the few films coming out at this time.
Right. Now, Hitchcock reportedly said that 90% of filmmaking was casting. And so I would like to know, do you think that's true once you've secured Hilary Swank and Michael Ealy for your leads?
Yeah, I think that's true. I mean, obviously, I think it starts with the script first, right? It starts with the script. It starts with the story and who your audience is and knowing who your audience is, right? And that filmmaker, you know, there's a lot of great talent out there. It doesn't have to be the Hillary Swanks of the world, you know, to be able to come across and get your movie made and speak to what's on that page. But I do think it starts with the script. Obviously, the layers of the talent layers that people have, depending on their expertise or experience, brings a lot more value. But there's so many up and coming actors and actresses that can perform the same job as Hillary did, in a sense, right? With giving you what you need. So it's like, you know, everybody was nothing before they were something, if you will, right? Like Hillary wasn't Hillary when she first started. So I think as long as you have that story on that page tight, that if you get that right actor that understands what it is and what they need to deliver, and the right director that can direct you to give you what you need, is so important.
Now, you have an inspirational story. You came and pulled up yourself by your own bootstraps, so to speak, and created the Hidden Empire Group, and it's been really phenomenally successful. What's the lesson that we can learn from that?
Trust in yourself. Take a chance on yourself. Believe in yourself, because if you can't believe in yourself, you're not confident in yourself. It exudes across all platforms, and if you can't do that, who else will? You know what I mean? You got to go get it. You got to fight. You got to scratch. You got to claw, and you got to get there. And it doesn't happen overnight. So don't be looking for that overnight success. Those days of being discovered walking down Hollywood Boulevard are over. No.
Hey, thanks so much. Happy holidays.
You're welcome. Happy holidays.
Take care now.
Bye.